Hello student, I am assistant professor Saidi Patil. Today I am going to start about some basic points regarding the taxation for taxation syllabus. So in this heading we just go through the basic concept of taxations various parts. So first point we will discuss here, that is, what is tax? So first meaning concept, and then we discuss some definition. So taxation, it is a tax or it is a charges. It is necessary to run a nation legally. The government needs to collect tax from the eligible citizen. So paying taxes to the local government is an integral part of everyone's life. No matter where we live in the world or anywhere. Tax can be collected in form such as a state taxes, central government taxes, direct taxes, indirect taxes, and n number of points are there. So therefore, whatever the taxes are there, it is divided in various parts. So tax, according to definition, a tax is a compulsory fee or financial charges levied by a government on an individual or an organization to raise revenue for the public works. So tax is a compulsory contribution from person to the government to defray the expenses incurred in common interest of all without any reference to special benefits. You can say tax is a mandatory fee or financial charges levied by any government on the individual or organization to collect revenue for public or whatever the social work. The collected funds is then used to fund different public expenditure programs. If one fails to pay the taxes or refuses to contribute towards it, will invite serious implication under the predefined law. So this is the definition and some explanation regarding the what is tax. The main objectives of taxes or the charging taxes, it is broadly explained in this slide, but we have some modern objectives also. So the rising revenue through the charging taxes, it is easy to collect and increase the income of public, government. The regulation of consumption and production, encouraging domestic industry due to charging heavy taxes on the foreign industry. And encourage to the domestic industry through the charging less taxes, stimulating investment, reducing income inequalities, promoting economic growth, development of backward region, ensuring price stability are the some basic objective of tax or the taxes, charging taxes. But in modern days, economic development, full employment, price stability, control of cyclical fluctuation, reduction of balance of payment difficulties and some non-revenue objectives are there. So it is important objective of taxation, that is economic development. Economic development of any country is largely conditioned by the growth of capital formation. It is explained that capital formation is a kingpin or the main part of economic development. But to overcome the scarcity of the capital, government of these countries mobilize resources so that the rapid capital accumulation take place. To set up both public and private investment, government taps or the handle the tax revenues. Through the proper tax planning, the ratio of the saving on to national income can be raised. So by raising such rate tax by imposing new taxes, the process of capital formation can be made smoothly. It is one of the important element of economic development is the rising saving income ratio, which can be effectively raised through the taxation policy. So the full employment, while we discuss the full, it is the level of employment depends on the effective demand a country desire of the achieving the goal of full employment. Must cut down the rate of taxes. Consequently, disposable income will raise and hence the demand of the for goods and services will rise. Increased demand will stimulate investment leading to rise in the income and employment through the multiplier mechanism. Price stability is possible. The taxation can be used to ensure the price stability. A short run objective of taxation, taxes are regarded as an effective means of controlling inflation By rising the rate of direct taxes, private spending can be controlled. Naturally, the pressure on the commodity market is reduced, but the indirect taxes imposed on the commodity fuel inflationary tendency. High commodity prices on one hand discourage the consumption and on the other hand encourage the saving. Opposite way effect the will occur when the taxes are lowered down the during deflation. So again, one more point, it is the next object, that is it controls the cyclical fluctuation. So regulation, consumption and production is possible. Periods of boom on this depression is considered be another objective of the taxation. During depression, taxes are lowered down, while the during boom taxes are increased, so that cyclical fluctuation are tamed. Reduction in foreign investment or the difficulties in BOP. The taxes like custom duties are also used to control the imports of certain goods with the objective of the reducing intensity of the balance of payment difficulties and encourage domestic production of import substitutes. Other parts, that is the extra revenue or the non-revenue object of taxation, is to reduction in inequality of income and wealth. This can be done by taxing the rich, at a higher rate than the poor, or by introducing the system of progressive taxation. So by this way, these are the objective of taxation. Now we discuss the canons of taxation. By canons of taxation, we simply explain that it is the characteristics or the qualities which a good tax system should possess. In fact, canons of taxation are related to the administrative part of tax. According to Adam Smith, they explain the first four principle or the canons of taxation in 1977. So the what are the first four canons? That is the canon of equality or equity, canon of certainty, canon of economy, and canon of convenience. So the more, according to modern economics, have added more of the list of canon of taxation. These are canon of productivity, canon of elasticity, canon of simplicity, and canon of diversity. So one by one we discuss the first point, that is the canon of equality. The canon of equality explains that the burden of taxation must be distributed equally or equitably among the taxpayer. So this sort of quality robs of justice, because not all taxpayers have the same ability to pay tax. Rich people are capable of paying more taxes than the poor people. So according to demand this rule demand that the person having greater ability to pay must pay large taxes. If everyone asks to pay tax according to his ability, then sacrifice of all taxpayer become equal. The essence of canon of equality, that is the sacrifice to establish quality in sacrifice, taxes are to be imposed in accordance with to the principle of ability to pay. So canon of equality and canon of ability are two sides of the same coin or the same points. Then canon of certainty, the tax which an individual has to pay should be certain and not arbitrary. According to Adam Smith, the time of payment, manner of payment, quantity of to be paid, that is a tax liability, whatever the amounts a contributor, and they must be aware about the payment of tax. This canon is explained a lot of saying it must be certain to the taxpayer as well as to the tax levying authority, that is the tax taxation authority. Not only taxpayer but should know the when, where and how much taxes are to be paid. In other, the certainty of the liability must be known before them. So there must be a certainty of revenue that the government intends to collect over a given time of period. Then canon of economy means when this canon or the principle is implies that the cost of collecting tax should be minimum as possible. Any tax that involve high administrative cost and unusual delay in the assessment and high collection, tax should be avoided and not be implicated. The canon of convenience, the taxes should be levied, collected in which manner it provides the greatest convenience, not only the taxpayer but also the government. Thus, it should be painless and trouble-free for a practicable. Every tax says a, for example, ought to be means it is it at the time or manner in which it most likely to be convenient for the contributor to pay it. So these are the four important canons are discussed here. Now we discuss some modern canons or the principle. Canon of productivity, according to well-known economist for the public, Charles explained that the tax must be productive or cost effective. This implies that revenue earned from any tax must be sizable one. So the tax said to be productive only when it acts the incentive to the production. Modern according to next point, that is the elasticity. It should be lived in such a way that the rate of taxes can be changed according to the exigency in the situation or the changes in situation. So it should be elasticity. Whenever the government needs money, it must be able to extract as much income as possible without any generating any harmful consequence through the rising tax rates. Income tax satisfy this canon, that is called elasticity. Canon of simplicity, every tax must be simple and intelligibly to the people, so that taxpayer is able to calculate it without any help of any consultant. Complex as well as complicated tax is bound to yield desirable side effects. A complicated tax system is expensive in sense that even the most honest educated taxpayer will have to seek avoid such type of or visiting to the tax consultant for the payment of their taxes. So such tax system has a potentially of breeding corruption in the society if it is complex. It should be simplicity. Then canon of diversity or variety. Taxation must be dynamic. It means it is a country structure. According to that, it should be dynamic and change. So the diversification in tax structure will demand involvement of majority of the sector of the population. If a single tax is introduced, only particular sector will be asked to pay to the national, leaving a large number of population untouched. So incidence of such tax will be greatest on the certain taxpayer. So the change or variety of tax diverse or the tax structure will result in the allocation of burden of tax among the vast population. So the what are the comprehensive variety, or these are the coordination. What is the meaning of coordination? Coordination means it should be coordinate to the people easily. Variety means n number of points are there, and comprehensive means it is useful and it is change. It will result whatever the rates are there, n number of people must be included in the taxation policy. So these are some canons. You can see it is a principle of taxation. Now we discuss types of taxes. They are broadly divided into two types, that is a direct taxes and indirect taxes. Direct taxes is that whose burden is borne by some person on whom it is taxed or levied. The ultimate burden of taxation falls on the person on whom the tax is levied. It is based on the income and property of person. So what are the examples of direct tax? Direct tax is directly allocated on the person's income, and it is included corporation tax, income tax, wealth tax, gift tax and property tax. Then what is indirect tax? An indirect tax is that tax is initially paid by one individual or one person, but the burden of which is passed over to the other individual who ultimately bears it. It lived on the expenditure of person. So indirect taxes, you can broadly say excise duty, sales tax, custom tax, VAT, GST. Now GST is your indirect tax, which is applicable in current situation. So these are the types of tax in this part. So, dear student, we discuss about the meaning of tax, objectives of tax, canon of taxation and types of tax in this video. In next video, we will discuss the various concept, basic concept regarding your taxation. Thank you, student.